The sun gets its energy from hydrogen, squeezing the hydrogen atoms until they fuse. So there's an appeal to the idea of using the sun's energy to make hydrogen here on Earth. The idea caught Stan Ovshinsky's imagination in the early 1960s when he sketched it out on a blackboard for his wife and business partner Iris and began experimenting in his storefront laboratory. His plan was to capture solar power to make electricity, then use the electricity to split apart water into its component elements, oxygen and hydrogen.
We went to the first solar meetings that we could, I never forget, they gathered together, had a big magnifying glass, and burned pieces of wood and saw smoke coming out and thought they were using sun.
And sold solar cigarette lighters.
Yeah, things like that. So I said, well, that doesn't make much sense. And so I thought that we would approach it much differently. And I started then the idea of the hydrogen loop, complete loop. That, well, where do you get your hydrogen? Start with solar energy from the very beginning.
Today, the solar energy business is booming, with billions of dollars being spent on solar panels to make electricity. Almost all these photovoltaic systems employ cells made from delicate and expensive crystals of silicon. But from the very beginning, Stan and Iris Ovshinsky had a radically different kind of solar device in mind. Here in a huge factory filled with machines Stan mostly invented himself, photovoltaic panels are made not from silicon crystals, but from multiple layers of the exotic metallic alloys the Ovshinskys use in all their creations.